Pretoria da Uloom Pretoria
kitna haseeno dil ruba darul Uloom Pretoria hai mar kaise ilme khuda da Darul Uloom
the event of Karbala and showing our love with the Ahle Bayt Atar. I would like to call upon my student Hafiz Furqan Nikoria to recite Manqabat Sharif.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sallallahu alayka ya Rasulallah wa sallam alayka ya حبيب الله صلى الله عليك يا وسلم عليك يا حبيب الله خدا کی راہ میں لٹنا حسین جانتے ہیں خدا کی راہ میں لٹنا حسین جانتے ہیں خدا کی راہ میں لٹنا حسین جانتے ہیں نبی کٹنا حسین جانتے ہیں نبی کے نام پہ کٹنا حسین جانتے ہیں نثار کر دیا سب کچھ نہ کچھ بھی پاس رکھا نثار کر دیا سب کچھ نہ کچھ بھی پاس رکھا کہ دین حق کو بچانا حسین جانتے ہیں کہ دین حق کو بچانا حسین جانتے ہیں خدا سے کینا دعا شاہ کے نواسے لے نعرے تکبیر نعرے رسالت علماء اہل سنت علماء اہل سنت پیر عمران عبدالی صاحب خدا سے کینا دعا شاہ کے نواسے نے یہ امتحان ہے ہمارا حسین جانتے ہیں یہ امتحان ہے ہمارا حسین جانتے ہیں دیا نہ پانی اگرچہ یزیدیوں نے انہیں دیا نہ پانی اگرچہ یزیدیوں نے انہیں بغیر آب کے جینا حسین جانتے ہیں بغیر آب کے جینا حسین جانتے ہیں نبی کے نام رہے نہ تن پہ یہ سر کچھ نہیں انہیں پروا رہے نہ تن پہ یہ سر کچھ نہیں انہیں پروا قرآن نے زیب پڑھنا حسین جانتے ہیں رہے نہ تن پہ یہ سر کچھ نہیں انہیں پروا قرآن نے پڑھنا حسین جانتے ہیں نہیں یہ دعویٰ کہ ہم ہی انہی کے ہیں طاہر نہیں یہ دعویٰ کہ ہم ہی انہی کے ہیں طاہر ہے کون حسین جانتے ہیں ہے کون جھوٹا کہ سچا حسین جانتے ہیں خدا کی راہ میں لٹنا حسین جانتے ہیں
Principal of Darul Uloom Pretoria, respected students, respected community members, we welcome our honorable guest of honor, Hazrat Shaikh Pir Ali Madazilul Ali, as eminent as you see, we used to assume that Peer and Shuyukh, Sheikh Uttari, old people. But here you see a young spirit. Allama Iqbal indicates about such people. Uqabi Ruh Jab Bedar Hoti Hai Jawano Mein. Uqabi Ruh Jab Bedar Hoti Hai Jawano Mein. نظر آتی ہے ان کو اپنی منزل آسمانوں میں When the falcon spirit wakes up in the youth they see their destination on the horizon So His Eminence has assumed responsibility to keep the flag of حضرت امام حسین رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ very high His Eminence is international scholar and he has a wonderful madrasa in Pakistan. His Eminence is an orator worldwide and especially he delivers lecture in the Islamic system at Birmingham and His Eminence is the director of charity organization the charity which is Bismillah Aid charity Bismillah Aid he is the chairman of that organization and in other words trustee of the nation Alhamdulillah we are very happy we are very glad to have amongst us this type of personality instead of listening my broken English I would like to call upon invite His Eminence to deliver to us a wonderful talk the personality who is coming from the motherland of English language so His Eminence speaks very wonderful English inshallah you will enjoy with Nare Takbir and Nare Risaalat, I will invite His Eminence. Nare Takbir, Nare Risaalat, Hazrat Peer Imran Abdali.
والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأهل بيته أجمعين. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. صدق الله مولانا العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين والفريقين من عرب ومن عجم. يا رب بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا واغفر لنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. بلغ الأولى بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله حسنت جميع حساله. صلوا عليه وآله.
Respected, honorable Ulama-i Karam, elders, youngsters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Firstly, I am very grateful to the principal of Darul Uloom Pretoria, Alme Nabil Fazil Jalil, Mufti Ahle Sunnat Hazrat Allama Maulana Mufti Muhammad Akbar Hazarvi Sahib, Tamad Barakatum Al Kudsiya, who once again has given me the opportunity to come here and say a few words related to our teachings, our practices, our beautiful religion. The last time we came here was on the last time I come, and today, Alhamdulillah, I apologize for not being here on time. Because I was supposed to be here on the 1st of Muharram, but due to some unfortunate reasons, I was not able to reach on time, and I am I sincerely apologize to Hazrat Qibla Mufti Sahib, the management of Darul Uloom Pretoria, and everyone else who has participated in the gathering in the last 2 days, and when they come, found me not here, and it's an unfortunate thing, but I had some reasons for which I could not make it. The list of topics which I was given, starting from the first topic, which is Risaalat and its impacts on human development. I will be saying a few words. I speak in English, and I speak in Urdu, and I speak in Punjabi. In our language, I say I normally make a khichdi out of a talk and present it, mix and match of everything. But I assume most of you here speak English, so I will keep my talk majority in English, and bearing in mind that the time is going to be very short as well. Aim and objective of these gatherings is not just to come here, sit here, listen, do dua, and return home. The aim and objective of these gatherings is to educate ourselves and to reform ourselves. In majalis ka maqsad hai apni islah, to reform ourselves. If we come empty-handed and return empty-handed, then we can say we have wasted our time. If we come in empty-handed, and the way we enter into the gathering, if that's the same way we leave the gathering, in the same state, in the same condition, then we can say we have wasted our time. Why? Because the aim and objective of these gatherings is not to sit, listen, say Subhanallah, MashaAllah, and return home. The aim and objective of these gatherings is to learn, understand, and to reform our character, to rectify our character, and go out and practice what we have learnt inside. That is the aim and objective of these gatherings. If we are going to be sitting here for 8-9 days, and in 8-9 days we don't learn anything, and in 8-9 days we don't understand anything, in 8-9 days we don't try to reform ourselves, don't try to change ourselves, don't try to rectify ourselves, don't try to get rid of our defects which we have inside us, then what is the purpose of making so much effort? What is the purpose of making so much effort then? So in the presence of these great ulama sitting on my left and my right, the teachers of Darul Uloom Pretoria, very learned scholars, and majority of you are students here who are also attached to books, learning and understanding, we will collectively try to move forward in a positive way and make these gatherings a source of blessing, a source of barakat, a source of forgiveness, and a source of reforming ourselves. You can say inshallah if you want. The time in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to this world was known as the time of ignorance. Darkness prevailing, sins upon sins. Everyone in the world was lost in darkness. Society was broken into pieces. There was no human dignity. There was no human honor. There was no respect. A normal human being had no value. And the worst of the worst examples are written in the books of history. And if we read them, our bodies will start to shiver. A servant, a slave, who worked in the houses of rich people, he was not allowed to use the water which was used by the owner, leftover water, leftover food, was not allowed to eat or drink without the permission of the owner. A slave, a servant,
was not allowed to even touch used water. Used water without permission was not allowed to eat used and eaten food. And if that servant and slave touched used water and food without ijazat, without permission, he would be punished, he would be whipped, he would be lashed. This was the state. This was the state. That a servant was not even allowed to eat and drink used water without permission. That water which is going to be spilt, that food which is going to be thrown away, without permission, that food and drink was not allowed for the servants, for the slaves to eat and drink. That was the state. And in that state and in that time, the beloved Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he went on the night of Mi'raj, when he returned, he came and said, "Oh Bilal, I heard your footsteps in the gardens of paradise. I heard your footsteps in the gardens of paradise." When there was no respect for a slave, for a servant, in that time the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Oh Bilal, on the night of Mi'raj, when I was in paradise, when I was in Jannat, when I was viewing Jannat, when I was viewing the gardens of paradise and the blessings which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for his servants, in Jannat, I heard your footsteps. I heard your footsteps." Allahu Akbar. When Bilal heard these words, imagine how happy Bilal would have been. The pain, the agony of slavery must have left him. The pain and agony of slavery must have left him. Allahu Akbar. Do you know when Makkah was conquered? When Makkah was conquered, Fatah Makkah kidin. If you open the books of Seerah, we see that the camel of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the transport on which the beloved Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was traveling, the Sawari on which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was traveling, on the transport and on the camel of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam traveling was a small child. A small child. Aapki sawari par aapke saath ek bachcha tha. On the transport, on the camel, on the ride on which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was traveling. When? The day when Makkah was being conquered. The day when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was entering into Makkah. The day of Fatah. Fatah Makkah ke din. Aapki sawari pe aapke saath ek bachcha tha. Now the question is, who was that child? Wo bachcha kaun tha? Who was that child? Was it the grandson of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Kya wo huzur ke nawason mein se tha? The answer is no. It was not from amongst the grandson children of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Was he from amongst the leaders of Quraysh, one of their children? Kya kisi Qureshi sardar ka beta tha? The answer is no. Was he one of the children of the leaders of Ansar? One of the leaders of Ansar? Kya wo kisi Ansari sardar ka beta tha? Jawab hai nahi, no. Then the question is, the day on which Makkah is being conquered, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is re-entering into Makkah. That same Makkah where the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was hit. The same Makkah in which the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was surrendered. The same Makkah in which the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was sworn at. The same Makkah when the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to walk in the streets. People used to throw rubbish upon the Prophet of Allah. The same Makkah in which Na'uzubillah astaghfirullah, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to walk, and people used to put ropes in the neck of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and pull them. The same Makkah in which the people used to say that he is Majnu, he is Diwana, Na'uzubillah astaghfirullah. That same Makkah which gave the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a difficult time. Today the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is re-entering into Makkah with his companions, with his Sahaba, with his friends. Thousands of Sahaba with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A great day of victory, a day of success, a day of rejoice. Khushi ka din, kamyabi ka din, jashan ka din hai. Fatah Makkah ka din hai. Allah ke Nabi Makkah mein dakhil ho rahe hain. On the transport of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a child sitting behind with the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is that child? Who is that child? Woh bachcha kaun hai? Tariq ki kitabe uthayein, sirat ki kitabe uthayein. Open the books of history and open the books of seerah. You will see, you will listen, you will hear, you will understand, you will read that the child who was sitting on the transport with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when the Prophet of Allah was entering into Makkah, that child is the son of one of the servants of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Zaid bin Harisa's son, Usama bin Zaid. Allahu Akbar. The day when Makkah is being conquered, the son of a servant is sitting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the transport. Allahu Akbar. Ek ghulam ko Allah ke Nabi ne apni sawari pe apne saath bithaya, dusre ghulam ko Allah ke Nabi ne Kaabe ki chhat par khada kar diya. One servant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the transport with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the second, Hazrat Bilal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet of Allah said, "Oh Bilal, you stand on the Kaaba and give the azan today."
Subhanallah, subhanallah.
Stand on the Kaaba and give the azan today. I mean, Hazrat Bilal stood on the Kaaba. Do you know what happened? Hazrat Bilal stayed quiet for a few moments. And he started to think that whenever I do azan, whenever I give azan, whenever I stand for azan, I face towards the Kaaba. I face towards the Kaaba. I was in Badr facing towards the Kaaba. In Uhud facing towards the Kaaba. Hudaybiyah facing towards the Kaaba. In Medina facing towards the Kaaba. In the surrounding areas facing towards the Kaaba. Whenever I give the azan, I am facing the Kaaba. But today, Bilal is standing on top of the Kaaba. In which direction is Bilal going to stand and give the azan? Aaj Bilal kis taraf muh karke azan dega? Allahu Akbar, the heart said to him, don't need to look left and right. Look at the beautiful face of Muhammad and start to give the azan. Wherever Muhammad and Mustafa went, Hazrat Bilal turned in that same direction and gave the azan.
Allahu Akbar. Ya Rasulullah, Zindabad, Subhanallah, Subhanallah.
Wherever the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, moved, Hazrat Bilal would look at the Holy Prophet and move with the Holy Prophet, look at the beautiful face of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and give the azan.
Allah.
Hajiyo, aao shahenshah ka roza dekho.
Subhanallah.
Hajiyo, aao shahenshah ka roza dekho. Kaaba to dekh chuke, ab Kaabe ka Kaaba dekho.
Allah. Subhanallah. Subhanallah.
People have returned from Hajj. People are returning from Hajj. What is said? That, oh Hajiyo, all those people who have had the honor to go and visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hajiyo aao, shahenshah ka roza dekho. Come and look at the beautiful place of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have seen the Kaaba. Now come and look at the Kaaba of the Kaaba.
Allah, subhanallah.
Look at the Kaaba. Kaaba ka Kaaba dekho.
Allahu Akbar.
You have seen the Kaaba. Mm. Now come and look at the Kaaba, which is the Kaaba of the Kaaba. Mm. Allahu Akbar. Are you with me?
Subhanallah.
Are you getting bored? Are you tired?
Allahu
Say Subhanallah loudly then. Allahu Akbar. So the groups of society, which had no respect, which had no dignity, which were disgraced, which were disrespected, the beloved Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came and gave those people respect and dignity and honor. Gave them respect, dignity and honor. If a daughter was born in a house, I am telling you the state of the world before Islam and how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and gave a civilized system to the entire humanity.
Subhanallah.
A system, nizam, how to live in society, how to move forward in society. If a daughter was born, the father would lower his head with shame. Ghar mein beti paida hoti to baap ka sar sharam se jhuk jata.
Allah
would lower his head in shame. What is this? This is a curse. Now to raise his head, in society, to raise his so-called respect, what he called respect, to raise his head, what would he do? He would bury his daughter alive. Beti ko zinda dafan kar diya jata. Bury alive. And then would stand up with respect and look up and say, yes, I am a man. Main mard hun. I am a man. Why? I had a daughter, I buried her. This was the moral state at that time. This was the condition of society at that time. Daughters were being buried alive. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that time, an age when daughters were buried alive, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet of Allah four daughters.
Subhanallah.
Four daughters. Aapki char sahabdadiyan.
Allah.
And the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the world the status of a daughter. In that time, when daughters were buried alive, jab bachiyon ko zinda dafan kiya jata tha, the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when his daughter Fatima used to come, he used to stand up and respect her and give her a reception and make her sit on the seat with her.
Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. Ya Rasulullah. Zindabad. Subhanallah. Subhanallah.
Would stand up for his daughter. Welcome his daughter. And the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to say to his daughter, come and sit on my seat.
Allahu
Akbar. Allahu Akbar. In that time and age, when daughters had no respect, were buried alive, Hazrat Dahiya Qalbi, radiyallahu ta'ala, a companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, he was walking towards the blessed Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he was not putting his full foot on the ground. He was lifting his foot and he was walking on his toes. Panjon ke bal chal rahe the. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seen him. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, oh Dahiya, why are you not putting your complete foot on the floor? Why are you not placing your foot on the ground? Why are you walking on your toes? Are you hurt? Are you injured? Koi zakham, koi moch, koi takleef, koi dard? Apna pura paon zameen pe kyun nahi rakhte? Hazrat Dahiya Qalbi replied, the reason why I am not placing my complete foot on the ground is because I have this fear inside me that what if a ant comes underneath my feet and gets crushed on the day of Qiyamat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question me that were you so big that you had no respect for the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
Allah.
That ants were being crushed underneath your feet.
Allah.
The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said so much softness. Itni narmi, where did this softness come from? Ye narmi kahan se aayi? Ye rahm kahan se aaya? Oh Dahiya, Are you not the one who used to bury his daughters alive?
Allah.
Kya tu apni bachiyon ko zinda dafan nahi kiya karta tha? Bury your daughters alive? Allahu Akbar. Hazrat Idaya replied, yes, I am from amongst those unfortunate people who used to bury my daughters alive. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, tell me, how did you bury your daughter? How did you bury your daughter alive? Tumne apni beti ko kaise dafan kiya? Zinda dafan kiya. Hazrat Idaya Kalbi replies, the companions are listening. Hazrat Idaya Kalbi says, my wife was pregnant. Umid se thi. I was going on a business trip. And in that time, business trips used to be for many, many weeks, months and years. They used to go and return after years. Kai saalon ke baad wapas lautte the. Hazrat Idaya Kalbi says, that I said to my wife, oh my dear wife, if a son is born, I want you to take care of him. I want you to look after him. I want you to take extra care with him. Agar bachcha paida hua, to uska khayal rakhna. Uske naaz nakhre bardasht karna. Take care of him. And take care of him very well. But if a daughter is born, I want you to get rid of her.
Allah.
Agar beti paida hui, to se khatam kar dena.
Allah ya zubillah.
Get rid of her. Hazrat says that I went, a daughter was born. Now mothers are soft. Mothers are soft, loving and caring. She wasn't able to bury her daughter. She kept her. Uska khyal rakha, uski parvarish ki. She became able to walk and talk. She put the love of the father inside the heart of that girl. Baap ki muhabbat beti ke dil mein dali. One day, after a very long time, the father returned from the trip. Dahiya Kalbi returned from his business trip. When he entered the house, a beautiful, innocent, small girl came running towards him, hugged his legs and started to kiss him. He looked at her, a very beautiful girl. Beautiful eyes, beautiful cheeks. Innocent, small, few years of age. He asked his wife, who is she? Ye bachchi kaun hai? She replied, she is your daughter. Ye tumhari beti hai. Time is short, so I am keeping it short. She is your daughter. Allahu Akbar. He became angry. And he said, I told you, if a daughter is born, I want you to get rid of her. Why did you keep her? Why did you look after her? Why did you feed her? What is she doing in my house? You have insulted me. You have cut my nose in society. Tumne mujhe badnaam kar diya. Mera naam zameen mein mila diya. Matti mein mila diya. Naak meri kaat di. Logon ko main kya muh dikhaunga? Ke mere ghar ke andar ek beti parvarish pa rahi hai. He decided, immediately I am going to go and end this story right here. I am going to go and finish her.
Allah.
He left his luggage, picked up a spade, belcha uthaya, digar auzar uthaye, the other goods of digging, took his daughter and started to walk out of the public area. He went into a deserted area. Ek virane mein pahunch kar wahan par khudai shuru ki, started digging. Whilst he was digging, because of the immense heat, he was sweating, plus he was tired. A long trip, that small little girl was watching him. That my father is occupied. He is doing something and he's working very hard. In her small little innocent language, she said, oh father, you have come tired. Why don't you leave it today and come tomorrow and finish your job?
No.
Come tomorrow and complete your job. Aaj ke liye itna kaafi hai. Abbu, aap thake hue aaye hain. Kal phir wapas laut aayenge aur kaam mukammal kar lenge. Hazrat Idaya Kalbi says, it still had no effect on my heart. Mere dil par us baat ka koi asar na hua. I continued. I was sweating. Suddenly, I seen my daughter move forward. Aage bari. She had a small scarf. Chota sa uske gale mein dupatta tha. اس دوپٹے کے ایک کونے سے میرا پسینہ صاف کرنے لگی.
اللہ.
She started to wipe my sweat. اللہ اکبر. He was asked, oh Dahiya, did you not feel no sympathy?
اللہ.
Did you not feel no mercy? کیا تمہارے دل کے اندر کوئی رحم پیدا نہیں ہوا؟ کیا تمہارا دل نرم نہیں ہوا؟ No, my heart was cold. I was stone-hearted. I felt no sympathy and I felt no mercy inside my heart. Then what happened? Hazrat Dahiya Kalbi says, I continued digging. میں کھدائی کرنے لگا کرتا رہا. I suddenly looked around and I found my daughter missing. She was gone. I looked around and I said to myself, she's gone, she's disappeared. That's even better. My job is over. میرا کام آسان ہو گیا, خود ہی غائب ہو گئی, پتہ نہیں کہاں چلی گئی. After a few moments, I see in a distance she is returning. She is returning. وہ واپس آ رہی ہے. When she got close to me, she said to me, oh father, you are very tired and you are sweating. We have no water with us. From the stream of water close to us, I have wet my scarf. I want you to suck it and drink the water.
Allah.
Suck it and drink the water. Allahu Akbar. Oh Dahiya, did you not feel no sympathy? Did you not feel no mercy? کیا تمہارا دل اس وقت بھی نرم نہیں ہوا جب تمہاری بیٹی اپنا دوپٹہ پانی میں بھگو کر تمہارے لیے لے کر آئی؟ اللہ اکبر. حضرت دہیا قلبی جواب دیتے, نہیں, میرے دل میں کوئی رحم پیدا نہیں ہوا. پتھر بھی ہوتا تو پگھل جاتا, لیکن میرا دل نہیں پگھلا. اللہ اکبر. حضرت دہیا قلبی says, I finished my job. Digging completed. I stepped out of the grave and I pushed my daughter into the grave. میں باہر نکلا اور اپنی بیٹی کو میں نے دھکا دیا. Threw her inside the grave. Her eyes stayed wide open. آنکھیں پھٹی کی پھٹی رہ گئیں کہ معاملہ کیا ہے, ماجرا کیا ہے, what is happening here. I started to put soil upon her. I started to put the soil upon her. She was crying. She was screaming. She was weeping. وہ رو رہی تھی. وہ چلا رہی تھی. And what does the Quran say? وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. I buried her alive. But I had no sympathy in my heart. My heart had no mercy inside it. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, oh Dahiya Kalbi, you are such a cold-hearted person. You are such a stone-hearted person that you buried your daughter alive in that state and felt no mercy. اور تمہارے دل کے اندر کوئی رحم پیدا نہیں ہوا, تمہارا دل موم نہیں ہوا. اے دہیا بتا, اب تیرا دل موم کیسے ہو گیا ہے؟
اللہ.
How has your heart become soft today? حضرت دہیا قلبی replies, I was a very cold-hearted person. I was a very stone-hearted person. My heart became soft ever since I have become the servant of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Allahu Akbar. Ya Rasulullah. Zindabad.
Allah.
Subhanallah.
I was a cold-hearted person. پتھر دل انسان تھا. لیکن یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, جب سے آپ کی غلامی کا پٹا میں نے اپنے گلے میں ڈالا ہے, میرا پتھر دل نرم ہو گیا ہے.
اللہ.
It is the صدقہ of رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. It is the blessings of رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. It is the teachings of رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. It is the practices of رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. This was the moral state of society at that time. And the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they came, they gave rights to humans. They gave rights to humanity. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, slaves got rights. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, women got rights. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, parents got rights. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, children got rights. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, the orphans got rights. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, widows got rights. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, animals got rights. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came, took out the society from the valleys of darkness into light, into glow, into shine, and showed people the way to live a life. جینے کا سلیقہ دکھایا, جینے کا راستہ دکھایا, ایک نظام ek system ata kiya. Allahu Akbar. This was and this is the message of Islam. This is the message of Islam. Today we have misunderstood our message. Today we have misunderstood our teachings. Today we have misunderstood our practices. Today we have been unable to convey our message to the outside world. It is important that we understand what is the message of Islam. It is important that we understand what is the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is important that we understand what are the teachings and practices of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The message of Islam, what is it? Do we know? The message of Islam is the message of peace. The message of Islam is the message of peace. Islam stands for peace. Islam ka pegham, aman ka pegham hai. Do you agree or not? If you do, say Subhanallah.
Subhanallah.
Islam stands for peace. Islam stands for tolerance. Islam stands for mutual understanding. Islam stands for harmony. Islam stands for love. Islam stands for compassion. Islam stands for dignity. Islam stands for equality. Islam ka pegham aman ka pegham hai. Islam ka pegham bardasht ka pegham hai. Islam ka pegham rehmat ka pegham hai. Islam ka pegham akhwat ka pegham hai. Islam ka pegham aitmad ka pegham hai. Islam ka pegham barabari ka pegham hai. Islam ka pegham pyar ka pegham hai. Islam stands up against all forms of militancy. And Islam stands against all forms of extremism. And Islam stands against all forms of terrorism. Islam does not promote terrorism. Islam does not promote extremism. Islam does not promote violence. Islam promotes unity. Islam promotes equality. Islam promotes love. Islam promotes respect. Islam promotes dignity. It is important that we understand our message. It's important that we understand our message. Why have we failed to get the message across to the world outside and convey the right message of Islam? Because we have not understood our message. Humne apne pegham ko samjha hi nahi. Humne apne nizam ko samjha nahi. Humne apni talimat ko samjha nahi. And that is why we have failed to convey the real message of Islam to the outside world. Allahu Akbar. The time before, the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the time of ignorance. Brutality was at its peaks. Violence was at its peaks. Extremism was at its peaks. It is the beloved Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who came and showed people how to love each other. How to respect each other. How to honor each other. How to give dignity to each other. And how to interact with each other. It is the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started to preach, people started to accept Islam. You're not tired, are you? Are you getting bored? Are you understanding what I'm saying? Are you sure? Good. Just, I'll take a few more minutes. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started to preach. People started to enter into Islam. But the Meccans gave a very difficult time to the Muslims. They started to harm the Muslims, hurt the Muslims, oppress the Muslims, kill the Muslims. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Muslims to migrate. Ordered the Muslims to migrate to different areas. The Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the leadership of Jafar bin Abi Talib, who is the cousin brother of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sent a delegation towards Habsha, King Najashi. Ek wafad Jafar bin Abi Talib ki qiyadat mein Habsha ki taraf ravana farmaya. Go to King Najashi. Tell him who you are. Tell him who we are. And ask him if you can stay in Habsha, Abyssinia. The delegation started to travel towards Habsha. When the Meccans found out that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has sent a delegation to King Najashi, and King Najashi will give them protection, they decided to send a delegation to King Najashi. Kuffar ne bhi ek wafad tayar kiya, jo Najashi ke paas jayega, اور جا کر مکہ والوں کا پیغام نجاشی کو دے گا. And go and tell Najashi that these people are traitors. یہ تو باغی ہیں. They are traitors and they should not be given protection here. انہیں یہاں حفاظت نہ دی جائے, رہنے کی جگہ نہ دی جائے, انہیں واپس مکہ والوں کے حوالے کیا جائے. یہ باغی ہیں, they are traitors and they must be punished accordingly. They sent a delegation. That delegation reached King Najashi before the Muslims reached. They said to King Najashi, "Oh Najashi, a group is coming towards you. They are traitors of Makkah. They have betrayed us and they have left Makkah and they are coming here for protection. We want you to hand them over to us. Hamare hawale kar de, hum unhe wapas leke jayenge, unhe wahan par saza di jayegi." King Najashi said, "Let them come. Let them come. Unhe aane do." When they came into the court of King Najashi, the royal court of King Najashi, and one side is Jafar bin Abi Talib, the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the representative of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the leader of the delegation. On the other side is the leader of the kuffar of Makkah. King Najashi first heard the delegation of Makkah. ان کی بات سنی, جو مکہ والے تھے, جو کفار تھے, ان کی بات سننے کے بعد نجاشی نے کہا, اے مسلمانوں, اب تمہاری باری ہے, اب تم بتاؤ تم کون ہو. Who are you? What is your religion? What is your religion? تمہارا دین کیا ہے? What are your practices? Tell us who you are. جعفر بن ابی طالب, who is the representative of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he starts to speak and now he is going to tell King Najashi what is Islam. He is going to tell the people inside the royal court of King Najashi what are the teachings and what are the practices of Islam. Jafar bin Abi Talib starts to speak. Jafar bin Abi Talib says, "King Najashi, we were ignorant people. We were ignorant people. Hum jahil log the. We were lost people. Hum zulm ki wadiyon mein doobe hue log the. We were lost in the valleys of oppression. We were lost in the valleys of darkness. Andheron mein doobe hue log the. Zulm, jabar, barbariyat میں ڈوبے ہوئے لوگ تھے. We had no respect for humanity. We had no love for each other. We obeyed no law. We followed no law. We oppressed the weak. کمزور لوگوں پر ظلم کرنا یہ ہمارا طریقہ تھا, یہ ہمارا انداز تھا جینے کا. Oppressing the poor was a way in which we lived, and we lived with pride that yes, we are strong. Our small incidents, shedding blood was common. Baat baat par hoon bahana, ye aam tha. Cutting necks was a game for us. Baat baat par logon ki gardan kaatna, ye ek mazak, ek khel tha hamare liye. Oppressing the orphans, killing the widows, burying daughters alive. This was our moral state. This was our moral condition. Ye thi hamari halat. Ye thi hamari condition. Us waqt Allah ke Nabi tashreef laye. Allah ke Peghambar tashreef laye. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came. The beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came. The messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came. And in that state, the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us towards protecting the weak. Guided us towards protecting the weak. They guided us towards protecting the poor. They guided us towards protecting the women. They guided us towards protecting the orphans. They guided us towards protecting the neighbors. They guided us towards speaking the truth. They guided us towards worshipping one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They guided us towards bowing and prostrating in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They commanded us to become humble. They commanded us to stop from doing indecent activities. Hamein Allah ke Nabi ne mohabbat ka rasta dikhaya, pyar ka rasta dikhaya, roshni ka rasta dikhaya. Allah ke Nabi ne hamein sharm o haya ka rasta dikhaya. Sharm o haya ka rasta dikhaya. Allah ke Nabi ne hamein woh rasta dikhaya jo hamein ujale ki taraf leke jata hai, jo hamein noor ki taraf leke jata hai, jo hamein roshni ki taraf leke jata hai. Allah ke Nabi ne hamein woh rasta dikhaya jo Rab ki raza ki taraf leke jata hai. Allahu Akbar. This was the message of Islam. This was the message of Islam which Hazrat Jafar bin Abi Talib gave to King Najashi. Allahu Akbar. This is Islam. This is the true Islam which we have forgotten today, which we have turned away from today, which we have misunderstood today. And that is why people point fingers at us. People point fingers at us. Some are calling us extremist. Some are calling us terrorist. Some are calling us violent. We are not violent. We are not extremist. We are not terrorist. We are those people who join societies together. We are those people who are uniting people together. We are those people who say love with respect and let others live with respect. Allahu Akbar. The Quran says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. If you want to succeed, and if you want to live a successful life, and you want to succeed in this world, and also in the world hereafter, then follow the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The best role model for you is the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you start to follow the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will succeed in this world and in the world hereafter. I always say that I come from the West. I belong in the West. Mera ta'alluq maghribi duniya ke saath hai. European duniya ke saath. I always say that it is in the best interest of the West to move forward. Maghribi duniya ka fayda isi mein hai ke wo aage bare. Move forward. Why? When the West turns around and looks back, they see total darkness. They see total darkness. When they look back, they see darkness. If you go back a few centuries, what was in the West? There was total darkness. Maghribi duniya mein andhera tha. Tariki thi. They did not know how to even write. Known as the dark ages. Andheron mein rehne wale log. Dark ages. So when the West look back, they see total darkness. Jab maghribi duniya mur kar piche dekhte hain to unhe andhera hi andhera nazar aata hai. Tariki hi tariki nazar aati hai. Total darkness. So it is in their best interest to move forward. It is in their best interest to move forward. Maghrib ka fayda isi mein hai ki wo aage bare, kyunki jab wo piche mur kar dekhte hain to unhe andhera nazar aata hai, unhe tariki nazar aati hai. But اے محمد عربی کا کلمہ پڑھنے والو, تم پیچھے مڑ کر دیکھنے سے کیوں گھبراتے ہو? Why do you hesitate in looking back? Why do you hesitate in turning back? Why do you fear in looking back? It is in the best interest of the West to move forward. Why? When they turn back, they see darkness. But our followers of محمد مصطفیٰ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, when the Muslims turn round and look back, we don't see darkness, we see the light of revelation glowing and shining in the streets of Medina and in the streets of Makkah.
Allah Akbar. Ya Rasulullah. Zindabad.
When the West looks back, they see darkness. But when we look back, we don't see darkness, we see the light of revelation shining and glowing in the streets of Makkah and in the streets of Medina. Jab hum mur kar piche dekhte hain to hum andhera nahi, ہمیں مکہ اور مدینہ کی گلیوں میں وحی الہی کا نور چمکتا ہوا نظر آتا ہے, ہمیں ایک نظام نظر آتا ہے, ہمیں ایک سسٹم نظر آتا ہے, ہمیں روشنی نظر آتی ہے, ہمیں چمک نظر آتی ہے. اور یہی دعا کرنی چاہیے, چمک تجھ سے پاتے ہیں سب پانے والے, میرا دل بھی چمکا دے چمکانے والے.
سبحان اللہ سبحان اللہ سبحان اللہ.
وی سی لائٹ, وی سی گلو, وی سی اے شائن, وی سی اے الومینیٹڈ سوسائٹی. So why should we hesitate in looking back? We are going down today in society because we have stopped looking back. Hum pasti ki taraf kyun badhte chale ja rahe hain? Kyunki humne piche mur kar dekhna chhod diya hai. Ki Muhammad se wafa tune to hum tere hain. Ki Muhammad se wafa tune to hum tere hain. If you become loyal to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you become loyal to the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you become loyal to the practices of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ki Muhammad se wafa tune to hum tere hain, ye jahan cheez hai kya, loho kalam tere hain. If you become loyal to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then what is me and you, then the entire universe shall become yours. But the condition is you attach yourself to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, attach yourselves to the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and attach yourselves to the practices of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because that is where we attain our blessings from, that is where we attain light from, that is where we attain illumination from, and that is where we attain guidance from, and that is where we attain success from. And this is where we need to understand that our success lies by attaching ourselves to the teachings and practices of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Society was developed because of the teachings and practices of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Most of the Western social system which we see, it is from the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the practices of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And inshallah, in tomorrow's discussion, we shall go through how the message of Islam was conveyed to the outside world, and how Hazrat Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, why? Because on the 1st of Muharram, it is the day on which Hazrat Farooq Azam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was martyred, the shahadat of Hazrat Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. So we'll discuss about how Hazrat Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu practiced, and how they made others practice, and how Islam developed, and how society developed through the time of Hazrat Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And that will take us towards the land of Karbala, and what happened in the land of Karbala, and how Hazrat Imam Hussain radiyallahu ta'ala anhu saved Islam, the teachings and practices of Islam, and how they saved society. How they saved society. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us all. May Allah accept our attendance here today. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept what has been said today. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this gathering a source of blessing and forgiveness for all of us. Did you enjoy what I said, or were you
Alhamdulillah.
Mm-hmm. Are you all going to be here tomorrow?
Inshallah.
Or shall I take my flight back to the UK?
No.
I have a very hectic timetable. I have a very hectic timetable. And I'm very sad with myself. I am very sad because I travel around the world, and I've come here to South Africa after 4 or 5 years, and you can literally say I come for the first time in one way. But I have two problems. Firstly, my health is not very good. Secondly, my throat is out of condition, and I am not being able to speak like I normally speak, and I am feeling sad within myself that what if I am not able to convey my message to you the way I normally convey my message and the way I should convey my message. But I hope you do forgive me, and inshallah ta'ala we will meet again tomorrow, and we will go further into the teachings and practices of Islam. I am grateful to Hazrat Allama Maulana Mufti Muhammad Akbar Hazarvi Sahib Qibla, who has given me this opportunity to come here and say a few words. And these ulama and shayukh who are sitting here, they are teachers, they are speakers themselves, and them sitting here and listening to a student of deen like myself, I think is a great honor for me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep the shadow over the Ahle Sunnah wal Jamaat for a very, very long time, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept their efforts also. Ameen. Jazakallah wa ma alayna.
MashaAllah, very beautiful beginning, effective, very effective. commencement with the zikr of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who is leader of the prophets, source for creation, and inshallah it will be end on the zikr of leader of shuhada-e Karbala, Sayyidina Imam Hussain radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And you won't deprive yourself. Next year when this month will come, who knows, he will be alive. So this is noble opportunity for you. And also don't be stingy, don't go alone to Jannah. Bring other, your fellow, your children, your family members, your relative, they also must be companion with you in Jannah. So in same environment, with love and respect, we will stand to present Salatu Salam in the court of the Holy Prophet alayhi salam.
Mustafa jaan rahmat pe lakhon salam, shaye bazm e hidayat pe lakhon salam, shaye bazm e hidayat pe lakhon salam, jin ko tauqe se kufi bulaya gaya, jin ko baithe bithaye sataya gaya, jinke bachon ko pyaasa rulaya gaya, jinke bachon ko pyaasa rulaya gaya, us Husain ibn Haider pe lakhon salam, Mustafa jaan rehmat pe lakhon salam, shamae bazm mein khon salam, ghauso khaja raza hamido mustafa, ghauso khaja raza hamido mustafa, ghauso khaja raza hamido mustafa, panj ganje vilayat pe lakhon salam, Mustafa jaan rehmat pe lakhon salam, mujhse khidmat ke qudsi kahe haan raza, mujhse khidmat ke qudsi kahe کہ قدسی کہیں ہاں رضا, مصطفیٰ جان رحمت پہ لاکھوں سلام, شمعِ بزمِ ہدایت پہ لاکھوں سلام, مصطفیٰ جان رحمت پہ لاکھوں سلام.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وعلى آله وصحبه وامته اجمعين. مولا کریم, اس محفل پاک میں آغاز سے اب تک جو کچھ پیش ہوا اپنے خاص فضل سے اپنی بارگاہ میں قبول فرما, کوتاہی ہے مولا کریم درگزر فرما. مولا کریم, بہت ہی اچھے انداز میں قبلہ صاحب زادہ صاحب نے بیان کیا, ان کو اور برکتیں نصیب فرما, زور بیان میں اضافہ فرما. مولا کریم, تمام سامعین کو سن کر اس کو سمجھ کر عمل کی توفیق عطا فرما. ان اللہ و ملائکتہ یصلون علی النبی یا ایھا الذین آمنوا صلوا علیہ وسلموا تسلیما. اللہم صل علی سیدنا مولانا محمد وآلہ وبارک وسلم. سبحان ربک رب العزت عما یصفون وسلام علی المرسلین والحمد للہ رب العالمین.